The unopinionated nature of React is a two-edged sword. On the one hand, you get freedom of choice. On the other hand, many projects end up with a custom and often messy architecture. This video is the second part of a series about software architecture and React apps, where we take a code base with lots of bad practices and refactor it step by step. Previously, we extracted an API client to share common configuration like the API base URL between all requests in the application. In this video, we want to focus on separating API-related code from the UI components. Let's have a look at the bad code example. Here's the result of the first refactoring step from the previous article, a component that fetches data from two API endpoints and renders the data. But what's the problem with this code? It's simple. API requests and UI code are mixed. A bit of API code here, a bit of UI there. But in fact, for the UI, it shouldn't matter how it gets its data. It shouldn't care whether a GET or POST or PATCH request is sent. It shouldn't care what the exact path of the endpoint is. It shouldn't care how the request parameters are passed to the API. And it shouldn't even really care whether it connects to a REST API or WebSocket. All of this should be an implementation detail from the perspective of the UI. The solution? Extracting functions that connect to the API to a separate place will greatly help decouple API-related code from UI code. In order to have a clear separation, we locate these functions in the global API folder. These functions hide implementation details like the request method, the endpoint path, or the data types. Now we use these fetch functions inside the component. Why is this code better? You're right, the code changes aren't huge. We basically moved a bit of code around. The result might initially look like somewhat cleaner component code. But in fact, we started to effectively decouple the UI code from API-related functionality. I'm not getting tired of repeating myself. Now the component doesn't know a lot of API-related details like the request method GET, the definition of the data type user response, the endpoint path user slash some handle, or that the handle is passed to the API as URL parameter. Instead, it calls a simple function getUser that returns a typed result wrapped in a promise. Additionally, we can reuse these fetch functions in multiple components or for different rendering approaches like client-side or server-side rendering. Okay, that's it for this video. But what are the next refactoring steps? Yes, we took a big step forward separating our UI code from the API. We introduced an API layer and removed many implementation details from the UI component. But we still have considerable coupling between the API layer and our components. Now, this might not be the most impressive example, so let's look at another one from the same codebase. Here we can see how the response of the feed has an included field that contains users and images. Not pretty, but sometimes we have to deal with such APIs. But why should the component know? Anyway, we'll deal with that in the next video.